amigos! Welcome to Learning Spanish with Nika Gal. I am Cristian Meneses Jacobs, tu profesora de español, your Spanish teacher. In lesson 6, we're going to learn more nouns and how to use definite and indefinite articles. Nouns are words that identify people, places, things, and ideas. In this lesson, we are going to concentrate on nouns that identify places. In English, the is the only definite article. But in Spanish, we have two, el and la. We use el to identify nouns that are males and la to identify nouns that are females. Nouns that end in O are male, and if they end in an A, they're female. For example, edificio ends in O. It needs the definite male article el and it becomes el edificio. Casa ends in A. It needs the female definite article la and it becomes la casa. And of course, there are some exceptions to the rule. If the noun ends in D-A-D or C-I-O-N, it's always going to need the female article la, as in la comunidad or la estación de policía. But if the noun ends in L or S, it's going to need a male article, el, as in el hotel, el país. And restaurant and park will always have the male article, el, as in el restaurante, el parque. Let's take a look at these nouns. La biblioteca, la casa, la comunidad, el edificio, la escuela, la estación de bomberos, la estación de policía, la habitación, el hotel, el hospital, la iglesia, la librería, el país, el parque, el restaurante, el salón de clases, el teatro, el templo, la tienda, la universidad. Vamos a practicar. Let's practice. Repeat after me. La biblioteca, la casa, la comunidad, el edificio, la escuela, la estación de bomberos, la estación de policía, la habitación, el hotel, el hospital, la iglesia, la librería, el país, el parque, el restaurante, el salón de clases, el teatro, el templo, la tienda, la universidad. ¡Muy bien! Let's practice using the definite articles. I'm going to give you a noun and you put the definite article in front of it. For example, teatro, el teatro. Escuela, la escuela. Now it's your turn. Let's talk about the indefinite articles. In English, there are two, a and an. In Spanish, the indefinite articles have genders. So we use un for male nouns and una for female nouns. For example, edificio is a male noun. So we need the male indefinite article un in front of it and it becomes un edificio. Casa is a female noun. So we need the female indefinite article una in front of it and it becomes una casa. Let's practice our indefinite articles. I am going to give you the noun and you put the indefinite article un or una in front of it. For example, templo, un templo. Tienda, una tienda. Now it's your turn. México. Make sure to practice these nouns and come back for lesson 7 to learn how to speak politely in Spanish. In the meantime, I would like to hear from you. Join the discussion and tell me about two of your favorite places to visit. You can use the definite article or the indefinite articles. For me, it would be la tienda, una biblioteca. And be sure to share this video with your friends and ask them to subscribe. Hasta pronto!